Have you ever stopped to ponder why we, the taxpayers, are funding multi-billion dollar sports stadiums? It's a trend that's been on the rise, and it's worth taking a closer look. Make sure you watch until the end for more interesting facts about US cities content. Imagine this, in Las Vegas, a city synonymous with high stakes and high rollers, the Oakland Athletics are about to hit home runs in a brand new ballpark, just a stone's throw away from the Raiders' new home. These two stadiums are set to receive over $1.1 billion of public funding, excluding any tax breaks. But it doesn't stop there. Over in the Windy City, Chicago, Jerry Reinsdorf, the owner of the White Sox, is eyeing roughly $1 billion in public funding for a new stadium in the South Loop. Simultaneously, the Hollis-McCaskey family, the Bears' owners, are requesting a whopping $2.4 billion for a new football stadium on the lakefront. It's a similar story in Cleveland, a city with one of the highest childhood poverty rates in the nation, and in Phoenix, Philadelphia, and St. Louis. In Buffalo, the Bills recently pocketed $850 million for a new stadium, while over in Nashville, the Titans scored a record-breaking $1.26 billion subsidy. But here's the kicker. Despite the astronomical figures, these subsidies are a losing game for taxpayers. Over the past 34 years, almost $30 billion have been spent on stadiums, and that's not even accounting for property tax exemptions or federal revenues lost to tax-exempt municipal bonds. These stadiums, as grand and impressive as they may be, fail to generate enough economic activity to pay back the public investment involved in building them. This is especially true when you consider lease agreements that redirect revenue back to owners or allow teams to play in the stadiums rent-free. Even if we consider these as an investment in community spirit, the price tag makes it hard to justify. As economist J.C. Bradbury puts it, when you ask economists if we should fund sports stadiums, they can't say no fast enough. So why are we still doing it? It's time to think critically about the issue of stadium subsidies. We must question the economic logic behind these decisions and demand transparency and accountability. After all, isn't that the essence of a democratic society? Make sure to like, share, subscribe, and comment for more facts on US Cities content.